Today we're talking about editing reels. I have gotten so many specific questions on my Ultimate Guide to Facebook Reels video about how to edit or position text on a reel, how to add audio at a certain point. I even had one subscriber tell me that she was trying to learn how to edit reels and she had different functions inside her, you know, Facebook or Instagram reels platform than even her own son did on his profile. Clearly, Facebook, Instagram, Meta is not making it easy on us to learn this platform, so we need a new system. If we're going to teach and learn about reels, we need a system that works for everybody. So instead of wasting time trying to edit within the platforms, I have loved using CapCut lately. CapCut is a free mobile app for your phone that works on both Apple and Android devices. It also has some really cool features I'm going to show you today that I can't even do in my fancy editing software on my computer. Now, I have timestamps below if you're looking for specific CapCut editing questions, so I don't want to waste your time. But if you are new to CapCut, I'm going to walk you through creating a reel, adding text and audio. I'll even show you a cool trick where you can download audio from Instagram reels and use it inside of CapCut. I'll also show you that cool 3D zoom effect that you might have seen out there. So let's get started. I'm going to share the screen on my phone and talk you through what I'm doing. So once you have downloaded CapCut, let's go in there, click on new project, and then that's going to pull up all of the photos and videos in your library. So click on the photos or video that you want to use. Let me add that. If you want to add anything else, you can hit this plus sign and that will take you back. So now if you click play right here, you can see what we have. And this is the audio just from the video that I have, and now these are the photos. How do you remove the audio from the video? You just use your finger and select the portion of the reel right here. You can go down to volume, and you can turn it all the way down so that there's no more volume. Hit the check mark when you're done. If you want to edit any part of this out, you just go to the part that you want to be gone. You hit the edit button right there, hit split, and now you can remove a certain piece. What if you want to take this piece right here and move it to later in the reel? You just select it, hold your finger on it, and now you can move it around like that. Adding audio or music. First of all, you can always add your own speaking over it by clicking add audio and click on voice over. So we're going to hold to record. This is me making a reel. Done. Okay, so now let's try this out. This is me making a reel. Of course, that's not great. So let's take that out. You just select it right here and hit delete. Okay, now let's say I want to use some music. There's music already in the CapCut app. You can click sounds right here. Choose what kind of music you want. I've not listened to this at all, but let's just... Okay, sure. Let's add that. That has already been added in. I can, if I don't want that music to start right there, again, you just hold it down and move it with your finger. Let's get rid of this. I'm gonna delete that. Let's say you are browsing reels in Instagram specifically, because this is the only place I know how to do this trick. You're in Instagram and you find some audio that you really want to use inside your own reel and you want to edit that reel in CapCut. So let's just find a reel that we want to use. You can't just save the audio and download it. What you have to do is download the whole video, and then I'll show you how to extract the audio. If you want to use this particular piece of audio, hit the little airplane button right here. Add reel to your story. You're not actually going to add it to your story. This is just to do this little trick. Okay, so now this reel is here. Click on these three little dots up here and hit save. Now this is saving it to your photo library on your phone. Now if we go into my library, it is here with the audio. Let's say I want to use that music in the reel that I was just making. Let's go back into CapCut. Let's hit add audio. Let's hit extracted. Go to the video that I just downloaded. And hit add. Okay, so now that extracted audio is in my reel That's pretty cool, right? Now let's talk about adding text in Reels. I have a screenshot right here on my phone of a reel from Facebook. And so this is a good example of where to think about positioning text on your reel. I would stay away from the bottom third, also the right hand lower half. That is where like the little thumbs up and the comments button is and stuff like that. So you wanna kind of keep your text out of that area. I would keep the text kind of in the center and in the middle portion. So if you're in CapCut, let's say you wanna add text right here. And here we have this text button, super easy. This is text. And you can change the style, obviously, to however you want, make it something that shows up really easily there. I've been using these bubbles a lot, a little bit more fun. Click on it again to edit the text. So just make sure that you have it selected. So you could hit style again and change this to whatever kind of font you want. There's even some animation here that you can use. There are so many options inside of CapCut that I really haven't found the need to make the text in some other platform and import it in. So we're gonna hit check mark. And so now this is our text. Again, if you want to move this around, you just select it on the screen, keep it away from this area and away from this area. But up here is a good spot for text to not be covered up by anything else. So if you want to move it within the video, you just select it down here and move it wherever you want. And you can change the length by, you know, select it like this, change the length like that. One recommendation when you are editing with music is to edit to the music. So this song had that dun 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 dun. You want the photo to change on every time it has that dun 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 and not to just be like random. And so it's easier to edit to the sound when you zoom in on the audio portion. You do that just by kind of pinching and pulling out on the screen on CapCut. If you are on your CapCut screen, you can kind of pinch and zoom out, and then you can go back like this if you don't want it to be that far out. That just makes editing to the music a lot easier. Okay, so let's talk about some of the cool effects you can use inside of CapCut. There's a 3D zoom effect that is really awesome. So if you wanna add the 3D zoom effect to a photo, like how I'm gonna add on this final photo here, I'm gonna click on my photo, go down here to style, and scroll over to 3D zoom photo right here. Now, instead of just a regular photo, it looks like this. That's pretty cool. Another one that I really like is this one right here. Let's hit style, and it's the photo puzzle. Check, and that adds a really cool movement to your photo like that. Another thing you could do is, let's say you wanna use the same photo, but you can mirror it, like split it apart. So I am going to click on this right here. I'm going to split the photo. So now I have a second photo right here. Just on this one right here, I'm going to click, what is this? I think it's edit. Yeah, edit and then mirror. So now, even though the photo didn't change it, it looks like it's a different photo. It looks like that. Let's see how adding those different kinds of effects make the reel look now. You kind of get the point. Another thing that is really fun to add in CapCut that can also increase your engagement with your reel is adding stickers. So let's say at the end photo here, we want to add a sticker that's going to encourage somebody to like or follow. There is a button right here that says stickers. Let's click on that. There are stickers like here's a follow one, here is a thumbs up button. If you want to encourage somebody to click the follow or the like button, you could just like add this arrow right here. Move this arrow to where the button is that you want to point to, so it would look something like this. Of course, you can move the size and diagonal and stuff like that. Use stickers. They really help to increase engagement on your reels. Okay, so obviously there's so much more that you can do with learning how to edit your reels better, but I hope that this gives you a great start. And I hope that at least using CapCut is a system that you can learn that's a little bit more stable than trying to edit within Facebook or Instagram because they're constantly changing. So I hope that this was useful for you. If it was, if you would please give this video a like, and I do hope that you subscribe because every week I put out low cost, no cost marketing tips for your small business. Well, I hope that you have a wonderful day and I will see you in the next video.